Here's how to make one of the best pizzas I guarantee you've ever had in your entire life that just smacks any fast food pizza such as Domino's. To start, you need a killer pizza dough, which is simple enough. I use carbonated water because I've found that the bubbles make the crust more airy. Pour in 10.7 ounces, then add 2 tablespoons of a light colored honey. This isn't to make the dough sweet, it's simply to help our yeast react fast. Speaking of which, I'm using 1 packet of rapid yeast, however, active dry works fine. Dump your yeasty boys in, give them a mixy mix, then after 5 minutes you should see some bubbly, foamy action. If not, this means your yeast is dead, which means you need to get new yeast or you're gonna come back and your dough will not have risen and you're gonna be sad. In a large stand mixer bowl, add 4 cups of bread flour, 1/2 cup of whole wheat flour, and 1 teaspoon of fine sea salt. Attach a dough hook, then once combined, add in 1 tablespoon extra virgin olive oil and 1 tablespoon melted ghee. Slowly add in your yeasty mix, scraping down the sides of the bowl as necessary until it forms a rough dough ball that begins to release itself from the sides of that bowl. Once that rough dough ball has released, give it a feel, poke it, and if it's not easily sticking to your fingers, then slowly mix in 1 tablespoon more water until it is sticking to your fingers, just like this right here. Always remember that wetter pizza dough not only tastes way better, but it has a way better final consistency. I used about 3 tablespoons extra water. Generously flour your work surface, then knead your dough ball 4 to 5 times, only until you can form it into a ball just like this. Drop it in that same bowl with a few tablespoons extra virgin olive oil, roll it around to make sure every side of the ball is coated, then let it rise until doubled in size. This could take 2 to 4 hours depending on the temp of your home and kitchen. Once doubled in size, take it out, give it a few little gentle pokes, then punch it down. Knead 4 to 5 times until you can form into a rough ball, then separate that ball into 4 balls. The most accurate way to do it is to use a scale, get the total weight, then divide that by 4, but most of the time I'm too lazy. Pinch the bottoms to seal, smooth them out, then roll them each in their own separate container with 2 tablespoons extra virgin olive oil. Take them straight out the fridge whenever you're ready to use. I think they're best when you let them rest 2 days. If you can stretch your dough really thin but still see your fingers on the other side without it tearing, this is proof that you've developed enough gluten. Now that you have a killer pizza dough, you're gonna need a killer pizza sauce. Luckily, I got a quick and easy recipe for you. Organic San Marzano tomatoes are probably the highest quality you're gonna be able to find if you're shopping in a basic American grocery store like I am. Into a blender, dump a 28-ounce can, then go in with a couple tablespoons of a high-quality extra virgin olive oil. From there, add a 1/2 teaspoon fine sea salt and a 1/2 teaspoon freshly cracked black pepper. Blend in 1 to 2 second intervals because when you blend extra virgin olive oil at high speeds, it turns bitter. It's seriously that easy. Pour it into a jar and store it in your fridge up to a month. Now that we have everything we need to make an insane pizza, let's make 3 different styles. Whenever you're ready to make one, take a portion of dough right out your fridge. Don't worry about the fact that it's cold. Your natural hand temp will fastly warm up that dough. Heavily dust the pizza pill with whole wheat flour or traditionally cornmeal, then starting from the middle of your dough ball, begin to slowly work it out until you form those outer edges or what will later be your crust. Once you have it stretched out as thin as you personally would like it, drop it on the pizza pill and oh my god, a hole! We gotta throw it away! Nah, I'm just kidding. Gently fold that dough over, press it down to seal that hole, then always give your pizza a shake and make sure it moves before adding those toppings. Speaking of which, we're making a margarita style pizza, which means that we need 2 cheeses. Fresh high moisture mozz, I get it in the pearl form so I don't have to cut it, and Parmigiano Reggiano, or just Parmesan cheese, but trust me, this stuff hits different. Add a ton of freshly grated Parmesan, then 1/4 cup max of your freshly made pizza sauce. Trust me, don't oversauce unless you want a soup instead of a pizza. Add about 20 of your mozz pearls, then a lot more Parmesan. Meanwhile, be preheating a pizza steel equipped oven at 500 degrees Fahrenheit. After an hour of preheating, it's gonna be rocket hot. I keep mine on the second from highest level to increase browning and not burning. Just before sliding your pizza in, switch your oven to a high broil and let it preheat 2 minutes. Cook for only 3 to 4 minutes, rotating halfway through until the top is as done as you prefer it. I take it right out onto a cooling tray, then add freshly torn basil, garlic butter is optional, extra virgin olive oil is not optional. This one's sure to impress, and I've had a lot of authentic Italian people tell me that this recipe was excellent. You see how foldable that homemade dough is? And just listen to that beautiful crust on the bottom. As far as pizza styles go, this one's relatively healthy. But what about the people that value cheesy deliciousness over their health? Let's make what's arguably the king of American pizza, which is New York style. It is wildly cheesy, flavorsome, and an American classic for a good reason. It starts the same as the last one. Gently stretch out your dough, dust your pizza peel, a lot of Parmigiano, and no more than a quarter cup of your homemade sauce. For this style of pizza, the only cheese that will work is a good quality whole fat, low moisture mozzarella cheese and nothing else. Add about 1 cup, spreading out evenly, then top with a ton of Parmigiano. Give it a little shake, then toss into your preheated 500 degree oven until perfectly baked. This only took 4 minutes, and of course, like last time, I rotated halfway through. This is one of my favorite styles of pizza, but now let's actually make my favorite. Pineapple and pepperoni pizza just hits different, and if you've never tried it, you are 100% missing out. Add Parmesan, your homemade sauce, low moisture mozz, more parm, then a ton of pepperoni, and thinly sliced pineapple. The sweetness of the pineapple combined with the saltiness of the pepperoni just makes a freaking flavor bomb in your mouth. Cook just like normal until a golden brown and crispy top is achieved. Little extra virgin olive oil, and let them know in the comments if you're team pineapple on pizza. Let's gang up on them. The best part about knowing how to make your own sauce and dough is that you can create new pizza combinations that have never before been done. For example, you gotta try this one out. Air fry some wings, get them nice and crispy, then hit them with some homemade buffalo sauce. Once your wings are heavily coated in that sauce, dust your pizza peel like normal. Add a portion of your homemade pizza dough, Parmigiano Reggiano sauce, and buffalo sauce. Add a lot of whole milk, low moisture mozz, then your torn up juicy buffalo chicken pieces. From there, you simply cook as normal until brown to your personal liking. I hope you learned a ton of information regarding pizza that will help you become a better home chef. Once you try these at home, make sure to return to my comments and please let me know exactly how much your family enjoyed them. The garlic butter is optional as always, but the homemade ranch and buffalo sauce on a hot wing pizza? Oh no, not optional. Not optional.
It seems we finally found justice.
Be sure to subscribe and click that notification bell so you're notified whenever I make an upload. Thank y'all so much for the support. It sincerely means the world to me. I'll catch you next time.